Hello guys, today I'm going to demonstrate how you can upload Tableau data extract files to a Tableau server using COZYROC REST Connection Manager and Engine. Enjoy! So we start as always from inside the Visual Studio. What we have to do is we have to create a new Tableau connection. I have already set up here a connection, so it is not that complicated. What we have to provide here is you have to specify the Tableau server URL address. And then you have to provide the username and the password for accessing the Tableau server. All the other options can be left to the default if you think that you don't need to make any additional changes here. And of course you can check whether everything is working properly by testing the connection. Now what we have to do next is we have to set up a data folder. Upload for the Tableau is implemented through the SSS data flow. So we're going to drop the standard data flow task. And we need a couple of elements for the upload to the Tableau server. Let me just show you what we are trying to do. We are trying to, I have the Tableau server web access page open here. So there are two places where we can upload the so-called Tableau data extract files. This is one of them is we can associate a data source with a workbook, and another place is the data sources. So currently we don't have any Tableau data sources uploaded to the system. As you can see, it is completely empty. And let me go back to the Tableau server. So what we have to do is we have to provide a couple of elements for the Tableau upload. We have to provide the data source name. We have to provide the project identifier, and I think this is pretty much it, you know, the bare minimum for the upload. Now what I'm going to do is here is just set up the standard OLEDB source with a couple of parameters. I just want to show how we can extract the Tableau project identifier. So this is just for you to one quick way to find what is your project identifier. We select the Tableau connection, we specify the resource project, and then we go to the preview. So what we need is the identifier of the project where we're trying to upload. I'm going to be uploading to the default project, so I just copy the identifier of this project. Now I don't need this anymore, and I'm going to continue with my setup. So I just have an OLEDB connection that I'm going to use as a convenient source for my upload. I'm going to specify, just like I said, the name of the data source, which can be anything that is acceptable by Tableau. So we have the name of the data source. Then we are going to copy the project identifier that I just grabbed from the other screen. This is going to be the project ID. And now I need to specify the file name of the file that I'm trying to upload. So I already have the file created here. You can generate this Tableau data extract file using the COZYROC Tableau Destination component. So again, what I'm showing here is one part of the puzzle. But we have all the needed pieces for you to have a successful solution for working with Tableau. So what we are going to do is now is we are going to have to provide the path to the Tableau data extract file. So I'm going to go back and I'm going to specify another input that I'm going to be using, say test, and I have everything ready for the upload: the name of the data source, the project identifier, and the file name. I can click OK here. Now the next component I'm going to be using here is the standard import column transformation. This is out-of-the-box transformation provided by Microsoft, and it is used for loading the content of a file into the SSIS data flow. What I'm going to show here can be found in many places around the internet, but I'm going to give a quick overview. So we select the column that is containing the file that we would like to load into the SSIS data flow. This is the TDE file column. And then we have to create an output column that is going to contain the actual content of the file that we are trying to upload. So this is going to be named content, type dt underscore image, and we need this identifier because we are going to set it up here inside the input columns TDE file. This is the file data column. It says specifies the ID of the output column to receive the file data. So this is going to be the identifier from here. And we are ready. We have the input for the parameters that are needed for loading into Tableau. We have the binary file for the TDE file. And now we are going to set up the COZYROC REST destination component that is going to do the actual upload. So again, selecting the Tableau connection, we're going to be using the action create, and the resource is going to be data source. Now, here is one important thing to have into consideration. It is mandatory to specify the batch size to be 1. And this is mandatory because otherwise the binary file that we are trying to upload is not going to be preserved properly into memory. So it is essential for this to be set to 1. Now we are going to the mapping page. The content is already automatically mapped, also the name. So the only thing that we are left to set is the project identifier. And I'm going to connect it now. So we have everything set up now. I think that we are ready to go. Let me just set a breakpoint here so you can see that we are doing an upload to Tableau. I'm going to show you that this upload is actually happening. So I'm going to execute the package now. Just give us a second. Okay, we have stopped. Now I'm going to enable our very good friend Feedware. And it is now capturing, and I'm going to execute the package now. And it is running now. And we have success. So file has been uploaded. And let me just show you that this actually happened. You know, as you can see, the file was sent to the Tableau server. This is the request inside Feedware. The file is approximately 5 megabytes in size. It is a small file. Just keep in mind that you can upload as much Tableau data extract files as you want, because the configuration for the Tableau REST API is streaming, meaning that it can upload unlimited amounts of files to the server. So we have uploaded the Tableau file, and just to show you that this file is actually now there, I'm going to go back to the Tableau web interface, and you can see that we now have a new Tableau data source that it's ready to use in your Tableau projects. So this is how you actually make your Tableau uploads using the COZYROC REST destination. It is really easy, and I think that this is going to give you a very good head start for your project. Thank you for watching our video. If you have other questions or concerns, please visit desk.cozyroc.com. For more videos and content from us, please subscribe to our channel. Have a great day.